In this video, let's go over how to compare two tables or two sheets for matching records. And the same formula we'll use should work both in Excel and Google Sheets. Let's just, first of all, just understand what exactly we're trying to do here. So if you look here, I have this Excel file with two tabs. The first one is table one, the second one is table two. And basically, if I, for example, go to table one and look for this particular account in this list, if I do quick search with control F, you can see that account cannot be found here. Now, if I look for this one, so again, quickly, I'll just control C, control F, control V to paste, and I'll do this. And here, see, we're able to find that record. So instead of doing this line by line, we want to find a better and faster way to accomplish this. So to do this, we're going to use XMatch function. And I'm going to go over two different cases. I'm going to go over when you just have an account number or some unique key that you can compare. And then I'll also go over if you don't have a unique key, or if you just want to compare the whole row, if the whole row is the same in both tables. Let's first of all go by that unique key. So assuming we have that account number here and account numbers here, and that's what we want to use, what I would do, I would go here and I would start with equals X match. And the first argument here is lookup value. So for that, I'm gonna click on this account number, the first one in this list, comma. And after comma, we have this thing called lookup array. So for lookup array, I'll click on the second table and I'm gonna just select this entire column from this other tab. So this whole column A with account numbers. Now, of course, if account numbers were in a different column, you would have selected that column. Now at this point, I'm just gonna close parentheses right here in the formula bar, hit enter. And see, that gives me NA. And if you remember, when I was manually searching for this ID, I couldn't find. So if I take that formula now and just double click in a corner here to copy this down, you'll see here, I get this number 103. And what 103 is, it's the row number in the other tab where we can find this record. So if I go to this table and scroll down to line 103 here, you'll see that's that same record that we're able to find here. So over here, for example, that says 81. So that means if I go and look at line 81 over here, once again, you'll see we'll find that record. So basically the idea is that anytime we get a number here, that means we're able to find that record. And otherwise, if it's NA, that means we're not able to find that record. Now, if you don't care about looking at the actual row numbers, you simply just want something that says it's there or it's not there, what you can do, you can go back here and put this whole thing inside of a function isNumber like this. And if I close parentheses again here, because we have another function here, if I'd enter and copy this new formula down, double click here, you'll see now I get a false when the record is not found, and I get a true when that record is a match and it's found on the other sheet. One other thing I'm gonna mention, if I go back to just XMatch without isNumber for a minute here, like this, and just copy this formula down, so this currently 103 gives me the line number in the other worksheet over here. Now, that will give you the line number so long as you select the whole column. So if you remember when I did the formula, I selected the whole column A. But keep in mind that, well, let's say you add some rows here on top. Let's say this is the way your table is. Now, once again, if you go to this other tab, currently, if you look at this, it says 111. And if I go to the other table here, you'll see that 111 will have that particular record. So it's still the row number in which it was able to find this. However, that's the row number so long as you did this whole column A. However, if you end up doing something like this, so let's say you do X match, you point to this account number, comma, and then you go to this other table, and instead of selecting this whole column A, you start selecting from here and all the way down, let's say Control Shift down to select this data. So you can see now that's a range. I'm gonna close parentheses, hit enter, and that gives me now NA. And because it's not a column, it's a range, before I copy it down, I have to lock the range. So I'm gonna select this data and do F4. If you don't understand what this dollar signs do, I have videos covering absolute and relative references. You should watch that. It's a separate topic. But here, if I just take this and double click in a corner, you can see now I don't get 111, I get 102. Because now what happens, instead of basically giving me the row number in a spreadsheet, what it's gonna do, it's gonna look for this particular ID and it's gonna go through this list. And since I started over here, it's gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And it's gonna keep going like this until that number that we had, like 102. So 102 will be the position. So it's no longer the row number in the whole column. It's just the position in that list. So if you want the row number, basically, you wanna make sure you do the whole column. So here, instead of selecting a range after comma, you would go here and grab the whole column A, like this. And this way, if you'd enter and copy this formula down, double click here, it will give me the row number. And also you don't have to do that F4 because you select the whole column. So there we go. That gives us whether the record is on the other table or not. And again, the same exact thing works in Google Sheets exactly the same way. If I just copy this formula exactly the way it is, go to Google Sheets and just paste it over here, you can see I get the same result. If I copy it down again, it says line 103, 81, 32, etc. And once again, if you just want true and false, you can use is number function around this whole thing. And then that will give you true and false if you just copy that formula down. So that's that. So this is assuming you have an actual unique key you can use to do this sort of thing. Now, if you don't have unique key, or your intention is not just checking the key, is making sure the whole row of data is exactly the same in all of these columns, you're gonna add an extra step. And that is gonna look like this. So I'm gonna delete this. And here, I'm gonna first start by using a function called textJoin. And textJoin function basically just combines multiple things together. And it allows you to put some special character in the middle of those combined things. So I'm gonna put a character like an email sign. You really just wanna use a character that's unlikely to be in your data. So something like an underscore could be a good idea, or an email sign, something that you think you don't have in your data, try to use that, comma. And then for ignore empty, I'm gonna do false, comma. And then finally, for the last one, I'm just gonna select all the columns in this row, like this. And if I close parentheses, hit enter, basically what that's gonna do is just gonna combine all of this data to one cell separated by underscores. And at this point, if I go to the corner here and double click to copy this down, it will do the same exact thing for every line in this particular data. Now I need that same thing on the other table too. So I'll go here and do over here, that same text join. And then as a delimiter, I'll use the underscore, comma, and then ignore empty. I'm gonna go false. And then again, I'm gonna select all of these, close parentheses, hit enter, and copy that down. So now that I have this new column of joint information, that's what I'm gonna use to match those records. So that means, again, I'll go right next to this. This is just flowing over here because it's a long data column, but here it's empty. So I'll go here and do equals X match. I'll click on this combined data, comma, And then I'll go to table two and click on this whole D column with that combined data, close parentheses, hit enter. And again, it says NA because there's no match. If I go here and double click to copy this down, what are you gonna see? I get a whole bunch of NAs here. So if we go and look at, let's say this one, I copy this, I go to this other table, and we just quickly just search for this here. If you look here, it's the same ID, it's the same name as it is over here. The phone number here and here, see, appears in two different ways. This one is in parentheses, it's a little different. This one is with dashes like this, so it's not in the same format. So, as I said, if you want this to match, every single thing then has to match now, and the phone number doesn't really match because the format is different here and here. So we need to figure out a way to bring those both to either this format or this format. So what I'll do, I'll take all of these and bring it to the other format. So I'll select this. I'll go here and I'll do replace. And I'll search for parentheses opening. And I'll do replace all. And that's going to replace all opening parentheses. I'm going to also replace closing parentheses. And then finally, I need to replace this space with a dash. So I'll go here and put a space here, replace it with a dash, replace all. So now this seems to be the same format as the other one is. And at this point, if I go back and take a look, you can see once again, we get our row numbers. So basically my point being here is that if your data was the same, it would have worked already without having to do this replacement when I did this. So after we combine this extra column here and here, we can just do the match. And if it's the same, it's going to work. But if you have differences, even small differences like formatting is different or there's extra space or there's extra parentheses, you need to make sure that you normalize your data so it's exactly the same in both so you can compare them. And just to make sure all of this works the same way in Google Sheets, let's just quickly copy this formula. I'm going to hit escape, go to Google Sheets, and I'll paste it. I'll delete this. I'll paste it over here so that we'll again just combine those. Then again, we'll do the same text join here on this side. And that will be, again, delimiter being the underscore. I don't want to ignore empty cells, so false. And finally, I'll select this data. Close parentheses. Again, copy the formula down. Well, of course, here too, it's the same spreadsheet. So you'll see all this extra parentheses and all of that is going to be a problem. So I need to normalize that. So I'll go here and do find and replace. And what I'll basically just do here, I'll start by searching for opening parentheses, replace it by nothing, replace all. Then the same for closing parentheses, replace all. And then finally the space will be replaced by the dash. I'll replace this. Now it should be the same format. So at this point, I should be able to go to my first table and go here and do my X match, point to the cell, comma, go to this other table, select this new column, close parentheses, hit enter. And if we just copy this down, now we got the row numbers like we did before. And once again, if you don't want the row numbers, you just want true and false results. We can go back here and do is number. Open parentheses, close parentheses here, copy this new formula down, and there it is. That's our true and falses. And that's how you can compare two sheets for matching records. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like the video, and I'll see you in the next one.